Hey everyone, I'm Ava and welcome back to Delightful Dolls. Valentine's is super close now and I thought it would only be appropriate to do a doll Valentine's Day video. So in this video, I'm going to be showing you how to make 5 different crafts for your dolls for Valentine's Day. So let's just get right on into it. So the first craft that I have today are mini cards. This is a printable, and if you want to print this out, just click the link in the description. I basically just took a couple pictures with my dolls, kind of Valentine's Day themed, and printed them out miniature to make cards. This one over here is actually from last Valentine's Day, but I still thought it's super cute. Anyways, to actually make the cards, you're going to want to start by cutting them out. Once those are all cut out, I glue them onto some cardstock. Then I cut them out. I then fold them in half. You can even lightly score down the crease where you're going to fold, making sure to not actually cut through the paper. And it might even be smart to actually glue the card part after you fold the cardstock, just to make it a little bit easier. You can write whatever you want inside. To make adorable little mini Valentine's Day cards from my dolls to yours. Next, I want to make a mini heart purse. I'm going to start by cutting out a heart shape, so I fold a piece of paper in half and cut out half of a heart. And keep on cutting until you think it is a good size for your heart purse. Then I grabbed some craft foam. It actually doesn't matter what color you use. Mine just happens to be pink because I am gonna be covering it with a fabric later anyways. I take my heart and I trace around it onto the craft foam. And I repeat that for a second one as well. And then I cut those out. Then I have this kind of shiny red fabric, and I'm going to wrap these heart cutouts in the fabric and glue it down in the back. And I cut off any excess fabric in the back sticking out. So it definitely doesn't look that pretty from the back, but from the front, it looks really nice. And I'm just gonna repeat that on the second one. And now to cover the ugly backs of these hearts, I'm just going to glue them onto some red cardstock. And then I'm gonna cut those out. Now I'm gonna cut a long, thin piece from that same foam. And I start by gluing it near the point of one of the sides of the heart and continue gluing it around the heart so that there's a little opening at the top. Then I glue the other edge to the other heart. Then I made this strip of that same fabric. You could have sewed over and hemmed the edges, but I just glued it, and it's definitely not the neatest job, but it won't be as noticeable when I actually glue it on. But I'm basically going to glue this strip along the side of the purse to cover up that foam. And then I fold these little edges at the end over into the purse. And I'm gonna glue them down. And then I have this chain that will fit perfectly around the doll's shoulder. And I'm literally just going to glue the ends inside of the purse. Being honest, the purse is nowhere near perfect. However, I still think it's super cute. And looking back, I think it would have just been easier to just use craft foam, maybe in a red color, instead of trying to cover it with fabric, because it kind of made things a little bit more complicating. But either way, I still think it looks pretty cute. Gluing the chain into the purse isn't the best way of attaching it. However, if you put enough glue, it'll definitely stay in place still. And this is supposed to be an easy craft, so I don't want to make things too complicating. And here's how it looks on an actual doll. I think it looks pretty cute. And I do think it's pretty cool how you can put items into the purse. For the next craft, I'm gonna be showing you how to make a mini pom-pom doll pillow, just like the one over on this chair. For this pillow, I'm using a light pink yarn. However, you can use any color you want, of course. Now, I've seen these mini heart pom-poms made a couple times on YouTube before, but I just think they are perfect for doll pillows. So I'm basically just going to wrap the yarn around four of my fingers, leaving a little bit of space though so I can pull it off afterwards. And I'm gonna wrap it around about 130 times. Because my yarn is kind of thinner, I'm going to go on the higher side. So I might even go more around 150 times. But if you have thicker yarn, you probably don't have to wrap it around as many times. And then I cut off the ends and slide it off my fingers carefully. Keeping it nice and together, I'm just going to cut a small piece from the yarn. And I'm going to tie that around the big yarn ball we just made, pulling it super tight. And then just to make sure it's super secure, I tie it again on the other side. And I just cut off the excess. Then I go and I cut all of these little loops. This part's actually super satisfying in my opinion. And then I kind of just floof it up a little bit so you can't really see where we tied it. And it just looks like a big pom-pom now. Then I made this little heart cutout and I place it on the pom-pom. And then I'm just gonna kind of cut around the cutout so I can turn this pom-pom into a heart shape. And once I've kind of roughly cut around it, I can remove the heart shape and just kind of clean it up a little bit with my scissors. To make a super cute fluffy heart pillow. And I just think this is a super cute and easy craft to make. Now I want to make a cute little Valentine's Day inspired necklace. I start by grabbing some parchment paper and an eye pin, and I lay that on the parchment paper. And now what I'm basically going to do is with my hot glue gun, I'm going to kind of make a heart shape. And then I let that dry. And then because we use parchment paper, it literally just comes right off. And if you're not happy with how it looks, before moving on to the next step, you can always try again because it does pretty easily come off. And then once you are happy with your heart, I add a little bit of glue to the back to hold the eye pin in place. Then once everything is dry, I grab some nail polish. I'm using this kind of chrome red color. I think it's super pretty. And I'm going to paint that onto the heart. Be really careful to try not to paint the actual eye pin that's sticking out. And then I let that dry before I paint the other side. And once that's completely dry, I have this little chain here that I just attached a little clasp at the end to. And basically I have this little jump ring that I'm going to put onto the eye pin and then attach to the middle of this chain. To make an adorable heart necklace for your dolls that is definitely perfect for Valentine's Day or just any occasion at all. And lastly, I'm gonna be making some mini sweetheart candies, or as I sometimes call them, conversation heart candies. For this, I'm gonna be using polymer clay. You could probably use air dry clay just the same, but I got mine in all these different colors that the sweetheart candies come in. So I take a little bit of clay and I roll it into a ball, then kind of flatten it and basically just shape it into little hearts. And I use a toothpick to help me make a little indent. And I'm just going to make a whole bunch of these. So I made two of each color and now I'm just gonna go bake these in the oven. So I'll be right back. Once those are all baked, I use some sticky tack to hold the hearts down. And I grab some red acrylic paint and then with a toothpick, I just write something on the heart. I'm gonna do really small, short messages because obviously it's a really small spot to write on. And I don't want to make it really long. here is my first one. I intended to write XOXO, but I can only really fit XOX, but I'm kind of learning as we go here, and I'm just going to keep on trying to attempt small little messages like that. Anyways, I'm gonna do the rest off camera just because I really need to focus when doing these, and I'll be right back with them all painted. Here they all are painted, and I'm not gonna lie, that was a bit of a challenge. However, I do think it's definitely worth the end result. They look super cute. They definitely are a little bigger than the original sweetheart candies, but if I would have made them any smaller, it would have been impossible to write on them, and I still think they're a pretty decent size. Those were all of the crafts I have for you today. I really hope you love them all and give some or all of them a try. I hope everyone has a fantastic Valentine's Day. And let me know in the comments which of the 5 crafts was your favorite. Before we officially end today's video, I actually have a little bit of a bonus for today's video. I was sent a package by my good friend Elsie DIY, and I recorded myself opening it. I did film this a little bit before this video, so the background and things might look a little bit different, but I just thought I would include it in this video because I'm so thankful that she sent it. I actually want to open up this package that I was sent from one of my good friends on YouTube and Instagram, Elsie DIY. She is the sweetest person, so make sure you go check out her Instagram and YouTube channel, which I will link both in the description below. Anyway, she sent me this. I just thought it'd be kind of cool to open it on camera with you guys. So anyways, I'm just going to open this up. First off, I want to mention she left me the sweetest note, and I love notes so much, so I'm definitely going to read through this all, and I'm so thankful for it. So I kind of already know what this is, but at the same time, I don't really know how it's going to look, and I'm super excited to see. So let's open this up. Oh, that's so cute. Okay. Oh, that's so cute. She sent these little Voss water bottle earrings. Oh my gosh, those are adorable. Thank you so much. And this I am super excited about. So she sent this to me in celebration of me reaching 100,000 subscribers. But let's just open this up. I already know what it is, but I'm so excited to see it. First off, the packaging of this looks so cute, exactly like the real thing. Now let's see inside. Oh my goodness, that is so cute. Oh my goodness, I can't believe how well she did on this. It looks exactly like the real thing. Here, let me go get mine. Here is the life-size one, which guys, I just want to mention, I'm so thankful for you guys helping me reach this. It's literally crazy. I never thought I would receive this. But if you look, it's literally exactly the same as the mini one. She said in the letter that she didn't write anything like Delightful Dolls or 100,000 subscribers in case I wanted to do that myself. But I don't know if I will because I'll probably be too scared to ruin this, and I love it just the way it is right now. So literally the biggest thanks to Elsie DIY. She didn't have to do this, and it's so sweet of her too. I literally appreciate it so much, and I'm just blown away by how well she made this. It looks so good. And I really like these little earrings as well. I'll definitely be wearing them. Once again, thank you so much, Elsie, for sending that amazing package. That is just the sweetest thing ever, and it means so much to me. Before we end today's video, I do want to give the shoutouts for today. Amaya Harrington, Easy Snacks Cooking, and Barbie Show. Thank you so, so much for supporting my channel. And remember, if you want a chance of being a shoutout, all you have to do is subscribe to my channel, click the notification bell, and comment down below with the hashtag DDSquad. And you'll have a chance of getting a shout out in my next video. Thank you so much for watching. Don't forget to like, comment, share, and subscribe if you want to see more videos like this. And I'll see you all in the next one. Bye!